Hello everyone. I'm sure many of you who have subscribed to watch this update have been waiting anxiously to see how it's progressing. And I'm now ready to share my current status, my current development status with you. I'm sorry it's taken so long. I can only work as my health permits, and there's still a few more things I have left to figure out, but I'm sure this will be exciting for you to see, as we can definitely do some customized development for our AVC LAN networks on our Toyotas. So let's get started. First off, I have a spare navigation LCD module, which I purchased off eBay. It's not the type that's in my car. Mine is just a regular segmented LCD with the blue-black background. But I took out the interior of it, and I've laid out the new circuits that I need to make my current setup work. This may not be my final setup, but it's my proof of concept, my prototype, and it works as it is. I've replaced the original LCD with a 1024 by 600 color LCD, and the circuit board on the left is the controller for it. It has multiple inputs, as you can see, so you could always connect other things to it as well, although I'm not sure I'm going to end up doing that at this point. On the right, however, we have a Raspberry Pi. This is the Raspberry Pi 2. It's just happened to be what I had available, and I don't really need any more for this project at this point. I got a breakout hat for it, in which I recreated the so-called sniffer circuit on it, and made it look nice and neat and mounted it inside. Also has the potential for other future expansion, but it's quite a simple circuit, so this was the easiest way to make it compact and make it fit in this module. There is a button that would have been underneath right there where the letter B is. It didn't actually have it on this particular module, but it is in my blue screen module. And what it does is it allows you to turn the blue screen off, which is particularly useful at night since the blue screen tends to be a little bright and you may not always want it on. I may put it in there and try to wire it up in such a way that I can do something similar, or maybe add some other features, such as to change the screen to a data screen for maybe output from the OBD2 port or something of the like. I haven't really made a decision on that yet. So I'll be just going to put the cover back on here, and then I will demonstrate the power-up procedure. Okay, so getting ready to power up now. Right now, the Raspberry Pi and the LCD are both being powered by the lighter port with the USB adapter. So they're both plugged into USB ports. I've not wired it directly into the Dash's harness system yet. I haven't found or made a suitable plug to connect to the existing harness. That would be the ultimate goal if I can do that, but I haven't gotten that far yet. The AVC LAN will be connected in parallel to the pins that are connected right now to wires from the original radio, and it will provide the messaging for the LCD. Now, the LCD here and its controller do not have the actual module functionality that the original LCD will have. The actual sniffer circuit, I have created a modularized code for to act as multiple units. Right now, I've developed code that allow it to behave as the master AVC module, the LCD module, and I have a framework for adding a gateway code or navigation module code or CD changer code or anything else, so that this module will, the intent is that it will be able to replace or even add functionality that is already existing in the car. So there's potential to add additional devices such as Bluetooth or another, maybe a TV or mini disc changer or cassette deck or whatever else, the code is being designed in such a way that different modules will be able to be inserted into it or compiled into it. But right now, since the original LCD is still in the car up there, I'm going to let it handle the current LCD messaging, but it will populate both the new screen and the old screen at the same time. So right now the factory radio is not connected. So all of the AVC LAN master functionality is going to be handled by the sniffer circuit that is mounted on top of the Raspberry Pi. The Raspberry Pi is simply there to handle the display of the new LCD. Okay, so now I will demonstrate the startup of the circuit. I'm going to power on the car. Now again, the radio is not connected, the factory radio. So the activation of the LCD is going to be performed by the new replacement sniffer card. And as you can see, the information has come up on the LCD. I can change it with the climate controls. The rest of the information just popped up, as you can see. So that's working. And now we turn our attention to the Raspberry Pi. Is now booting up. And again, as a reminder, it is simply being used as a display unit. The actual AVC LAN control for the LCD is being handled by the sniffer card. Now, as you can see, what's come up here, the information is identical, except for the outside temperature. The code for that is working. I'm not sure why it's not popping up at this moment. I'll have to look into that, but it did come up earlier, so I do know it's working. At least it's translating data. It's just not displaying at the moment. But if we look at this, the temperature 24 on both sides, fuel range 498, average 9.1 liters, the trip time is 1 minute. If we look at the original LCD, all that information is the same. Now I'm going to change the temperature, and just for fun, I'm just going to change the passenger temperature. And so you can see me popping it up to 26.5. Now, unfortunately, for some reason, a delay has been introduced. It's not updating immediately, but there you can see it did update. It is processing the messages. You can see the average is 9.2. I'm going to change the AC control. I'm going to turn the AC off. See the AC. That updates immediately, just like it does with the original. Turn it on. Actually, sorry, and it doesn't display on the original. That's actually an added feature that I added on this one. There is AVC LAN codes that say the AC is on, so I've actually added this to the LCD. The recirculation, I did not add a code for that, apparently. It's not on the original either. And the last of all, the fan controls. Oops. Sorry, this is just sitting on my knee. If I turn on change the fan controls, or the direction. Now there's the defroster. You can see the defroster comes on and turn it off, and then it returns. If I change the direction of the venting, see, it all updates, and it will update exactly the same as on the other one. And if I change the fan controls, where's the buttons for that? See, I can increase the fan, and it will change just as it does on the original LCD. Apologize if it's all wavy. The video is not particularly stable. It's bright out, and so I'm also fighting with the auto contrast controls. So that pretty much covers it. I'm hoping to being able to extend this functionality, possibly connecting it to my Android radio. That would be a neat feature if they could be talking to each other, or the control also be added to it. And I'm open to suggestions or ideas. Some of the cars definitely have different master modules from what I've been researching. Some may use master AVC device with an ID of 160. Mine is 190. Different countries may have gateway modules with different identifiers. Mine's 1C6. Europe has a different one. I think it's 1C2 or 1C8. Russia, I believe, was 1C4. So the more information that is available, the more functionality can be added to make this available to everyone. Please comment below. Please subscribe. Let your friends know who have Toyotas who want to add extra functionality, replace the Raider, and have trouble with their components working as a result. I'm also thinking about creating a commercial device. I'm not sure how that's going to work yet, but I would like to make it easier for others to get access to this. So if I'm able to do that, that's something I'm looking into. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned.